Now, to start with, our lesson today is entitled Probability Distribution of a Discrete Random Variable. And our memory verse is found in Luke 1, verse 37. It says, "For nothing will be impossible with God." Or when you were kids, we used to memorize this: "With God, nothing is impossible." Let me have my paraphrase of that in a stat and prob way. I should say, with God, the probability is always one or certain. Now, I know in your MVCA boosters will be answering this. Why is God's probability always certain? Now, there this lesson, we will be able to find the possible values of a random variable, illustrate a probability distribution, construct the PMF, we just call it PMF, a probability mass function, and compute the probabilities. Now, here's a sample for the adventure activity. You need to get a 1 peso coin, and you need to toss the coin thrice. You need to record the output of your first toss. Example, if the first toss is head, the second toss is head, the third toss is tail, then you record it as HHT. Then in the last column, you need to count the number of heads. You need to answer these questions. Can the number of heads be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5? And why can't it be 4 or 5? Now let's have a very brief review in your probability topics in grades 8 and 10. Now let's start with the definition of terms. If we say experiment, it means what's the activity that you have done? For example, you're rolling a die. Let me remind you that it's not dice. Dice is the plural form for die. So there's only one, you just say, I'm rolling a die. If you're rolling a die, then the activity or the experiment is rolling a die. Another, you are tossing a coin. That is what we call experiment. Or in a slipper game, you are tossing the slipper. Kupara, hayang kulob. So that is what we call the experiment. Or when you go in front of your locker and then you're trying to match your OOTD, that's what we call experiment. And the result of your experiment is called the outcome. And if we'll have all these outcomes, we call it a sample space. For example, we are tossing a coin. So let me first share my whiteboard. For example, we are tossing a coin. So the experiment is tossing a coin or coin toss. Your possible outcomes will be head and it can be tail. So these are what we call outcomes. If I'll ask you to write the sample space, then you write it in a set notation. That's head, comma, tail. Or if you roll a die, the experiment is called rolling a die. And the outcomes can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. So if we write our sample space, that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 in a set form. Now, how do we know how many outcomes are there? Now, we have what we call the fundamental counting principle. It tells us that if one part of the experiment can be done in P ways, and the other part of the experiment can be done in Q ways, then there are P times Q ways or outcomes that we can have in all. Example, we roll a die twice. In the first roll, there are 6 possible outcomes. In the second role, there are 6 possible outcomes. Therefore, you multiply it, 6 times 6, there are 36 possible outcomes. Or another, we toss a coin twice. Then, how many outcomes are there? In the first toss, there are 2 possible outcomes. That's head and tail. In the second toss, there are 2 possible outcomes. Steal the head and the tail. We multiply them. We have 4 possible outcomes. That's the fundamental counting principle. Or when we toss a coin thrice, then that's going to be 2 times 2 times 2. That's going to be 8 possible outcomes. Now, how do we list the outcomes? We need to draft a tree diagram. That's the tree diagram. For example, in the first toss, your possible outcomes can be head and tail, or tail. In your second toss, your possible outcomes can be head or tail. Head or tail. Therefore, the possible outcomes can be head, head. It means both heads, or head, tail. The first is head, the second is tail. My whiteboard will not work again. Let me transfer to another one because my whiteboard is not moving. Here, like in the second toss, it can be head. I'm still missing the other one. Or tail. So my possible outcomes can be head, 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 tail, head in the first, tail in the second, tail, head, or it can be tail, tail. Now, if I'll toss a coin thrice, then you continue the pattern. Your possible outcomes can be head, 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 tail, head, tail, head, head, tail, 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 head, head, tail, head, tail, 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 head, and tail, tail, tail. So again, check first how many outcomes using the fundamental counting principle. And second, make a tree diagram. Let me show you another example, like this one. We do the spinner, that's red. We spin first, then we need to toss a coin. So the spinner can be red, green, or blue. Then match it with head, tail, head, tail, head, tail. So our outcomes can be red, then head, red, then tail, green, then head, green, tail, blue, head, or blue, tail. Now,